Well, you may remember our next guest, who we featured 3 years ago when their bath bomb business was just getting off the ground. Back then, they were just teenagers making the bath bombs in their basement. But now the sisters have turned this business into a multi-million dollar empire, employing 150 people. And by the way, they're still in high school. And now they're releasing their first book to teach people how to make their own bath bombs and bath scrubs at home. It's called Fizz Boom Bath. And we are delighted to have Isabel and Carolyn Burklaw back to Care 11. Great to have you here.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you so much for coming back. For people that don't remember or people that maybe missed the interview the first time, how did you get all this started, this business?
Yeah, well, Isabel and I loved using bath bombs, but we found that a lot of times it would stain our tub, and we were kind of feeling like something was missing. So we decided to make our own and put a little surprise inside.
Yeah.
So yeah, all of our bath bombs have a surprise inside. And with our new book, you can make these recipes at home. You can put a surprise inside if you want. It's pretty much optional.
Yeah, we really wanted to share the creativity because that's how we started.
Right. Now, who's older? Tell me again.
I'm 17, but I'm 17. Shorter.
You're shorter, but she's older. Okay, you're older and shorter.
Yes.
We got it. Okay, good. Why did you decide to write a book? Like, you didn't have enough things to do between running a business and going to school.
Yeah, I mean, the opportunity presented itself, and we, like I said, we really wanted to share that initial creativity that sparked our business, and we wanted to create more artistic recipes as well, and they're super easy and anyone can do them. And today we're actually going to be making one of the recipes, and it's called the Birthday Bomb.
Let's do
it. And it's actually really special because I think somebody's daughter named Evelyn is turning 7 today.
And she said, can I wish her a happy birthday? I said, yeah, I'm pretty sure she'll be okay with that. And she loves
birthday,
this stuff,
Evelyn.
Too.
So we're going to take 2¼ cups of citric acid.
Citric acid? Mm-hmm. Can you just buy that at the store?
You can buy it at your local co-op.
Okay.
And we're also taking
1¼ cups of citric acid.
We did the citric acid.
Baking soda, citric acid.
Baking soda, then citric acid. And I wouldn't have known which was which, by the way, so don't worry about that.
Okay. And then some cornstarch. And then we also have some liquid ingredients. We have some fragrance, which smells like birthday cake.
Oh, yum.
So we're just going to put that into our almond oil.
Okay, I also have to ask you, where are you going to buy birthday cake fragrance?
We have sources in our book.
Okay.
So if you don't know where to get
it. So you got to buy the book to find out how to do it. That's good business, see? That's why you guys are so good at this. You're mixing it all together.
Yes, I'm mixing all the liquid ingredients together. Mm-hmm. And then...
And you said almond oil as well in that?
Yep, some almond oil. And then after you've mixed together the dry ingredients, you can just pour these in like this.
How did you come up with learning the recipes when you did these? I mean, was it a lot of trial and error? Did you do a lot of research?
Yes, it was a lot of trial and error. It was a lot of weeks of just like kind of having raw skin because we'd been using so many face masks and hand scrubs. And we were probably a little bit spot out. So. But we basically started making the book just like we started making bath bombs, you know, a lot of research and a lot of, you know, just figuring out what the values that we wanted to have in our recipes, because that's how we started our business.
And so then you're mixing this together with your hand.
Yeah, like a hand washing motion.
Yes, so kind of like this.
And it turns into this.
Yes, it turns into this. And then we have some molds. We also provide sources in our book, but if you just Google plastic bath bomb molds, I'm pretty sure something will come up.
Yep. Everything's Google,
Google's
right?
Google's amazing. Oh,
You don't even know what it was like to grow up without Google.
I don't. So we're just taking some sprinkles, but you can also call these non-pareils if you want to get technical.
They're edible, which is good, but this is not. Don't eat this.
No. Well, you probably could, but it just
wouldn't taste very good.
Yeah.
It wouldn't taste like a cake.
Yeah.
Yes, but our recipes are 99% natural. So.
Oh, cool.
And then they're also food grade. And most of the recipes in this book are natural as well.
Okay. So you got one half. We got just under a minute left. So you put the two halves and you're just squishing them together.
Yep.
You just mix and you can choose your molds. We have two different options.
So this you would just leave in here for about 24 hours.
24 hours. Okay.
So it kind of looks like
Look at that. Maybe. And then it dries and kind of binds together and hardens.
And these are a little bit different colors because you can add as much pigment as you want and you can really get creative with the recipes. And like I said before, anyone can do these and anyone can get creative with them. So.
You two are fascinating. Thank you so much for coming in again. I look forward to following your career when this turns into a billion-dollar business.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Yeah, thank you so much for having us.
And this smells really, really good. You can find Fizz Boom Bath on Amazon.com and on DeBomb website. We have a link on kare-11.com. Now, how to be millionaires as teenagers, we can't tell you. Coming up.